Derek Tony, VarsitySportsNetwork.com. In the 2014 girls lacrosse season, Tianna Wallpher led the Mount Hebron lacrosse team to the Howard County title. She set a school record with 48 charges, 122 career interceptions, 94 calls turnovers, 43 blocked passes, 67 draw controls. And for this season, let's add also 15 charges, calls 36 turnovers with 15 interceptions, 11 blocks on a unit that only allowed 6.9 goals a game, which is pretty hard in Howard County with the likes of River Hill and Marriage Ridge. But this young lady rose to the occasion. She's going to UMBC. And she is our 2014 Varsity Sports Network Defensive Player of the Year. And Tianna, I know that you were the main senior on a very young team. Talk about that challenge and also talk about just how your young teammates rose to the occasion this year.
It was hard coming in senior year with the other seniors after having played with the same girls for over maybe 3 years, 2 years for some of us. And we knew that the challenge was that we were going to just have to adjust and adapt, and some people might have had to come out of their comfort zone, and maybe midfielders would move to attack or defense, and then attackers to defense. And so when the new girls came in, or younger girls, everyone had the same attitude, and that was just to get better each day. Mm-hmm. And I think that was the main focus, and that's why we had a lot of success in the beginning of the year with trying to focus on a team and just getting that chemistry down, which ultimately led to that success we had in the beginning of the season. And everyone just always had a great attitude, whether it was seniors all the way down to freshmen. Everyone was on the same page every day, and the coaches did a good job of making sure we knew what we wanted to accomplish.
Right. As a defender, in what ways do you think you improved from your junior year to your senior year?
I'd say there's a lot of things, and you know, always improving each year. There's always something to work on, but a big thing this year was a lot of cutters, because we had a lot of difficulty with that, and it's always hard to, you know, stay on the girl, whether maybe you are on and you think you're pressuring, the stick is still there, and there are amazing girls in this county that can make those catches and score. So that was a big challenge, and then really focusing on pressuring without fouling. Because, you know, that was a big thing, you know, get antsy and then you just want the ball back, and then that's when you make the foul and you put the defense in a bad situation. So I think those were the two main things, and it's always a thing like communication and talking to the team. So
you brought a high energy to the field, and every time I've seen you, it's like it's high motor, high energy, go, go, go. I mean, yeah. Kind of. Is that something you just wake up with? I mean, explain that. I'm just curious. Is that at a store, at the Walmart, Target? I don't.
It's funny because I know that my parents said that when I was younger, I actually played soccer. Mm-hmm. And by play, I mean I would sit down and I'd pick flowers, mm-hmm. or I'd be that girl who's chasing butterflies. Mm-hmm. And I'm not really sure when it really hit me, or like the intensity really came to me. And I think it was just years of just watching my siblings play, mm-hmm. watching other people play, me myself playing, and I just learned that, you know, hard work really does pay off. And you know that old saying, like, hard work beats talent when talent doesn't work hard. That's mm-hmm. like something I really live by, and I think that it's very true. And you know, I just don't want anyone to say, oh, she just got that because of whatever reason. I want them to say that, you know, whether I or the team got something, because we worked hard, I worked hard, and you know, we deserve it, or I deserve it. And so I don't know where that intensity comes from sometimes, and you know, I think the coaches help, teammates definitely help, rallying each other up for whatever sport it is, field hockey, basketball, lacrosse. But you know, I always know that, yeah, I want to win, and that's what really drives me.
Going to be playing the Under Armour game in a few weeks. Talk about that opportunity, and also talk about, you're going to be close to home, going to be playing for the Retrievers in UMBC.
I'm very, very excited for the opportunity to play for the area for Under Armour, and you know, it's a great honor. I couldn't be even more like humbled by that honor, and you know, I just hope to just go out there and just have fun with girls from all over the area, and just really, you know, bond over the sport of lacrosse, and just I get an opportunity to play with people who I play against, like Taylor Hench or Megan Little. Mm-hmm. I get to have them on my team, which I'm looking forward to. And then even people from areas where I don't know, because I think there's some people from Colorado, Florida, Pridemore. I've never played with them, and I think that'd be a great experience to play with them. And I'm just really excited to have that opportunity to play with other girls who are amazing at this sport. And UMBC, I'm excited to stay home. I really am a family person. I love staying near my house and stuff. So I'm looking forward to that. I'm looking forward to the team and the coaches. And everyone's just great there, and I really, really am excited to get started there.
Well, Tianna Wallpher had, again, forced 36 turnovers, had 15 interceptions for the Mount Hermon Vikings, who won the Howard County Championship and finished in the top 10 in Varsity Sports Network Top 20. And for that, Tianna Wallpher, Under Armour All-American, is also Varsity Sports Network Girls Lacrosse Defensive Player of the Year. Congratulations, Tianna.
Thank you.
For VarsitySportsNetwork.com, I'm Derek Toney.